Here is the original brochure for the Tandy 1000. It has a date on the back of October 1984. I'm going to scan this in and upload it, and I'll put the link in the description if you want to read the whole thing. And the centerpiece of the brochure is the DeskMate software it came with. And this is the original text-based version of DeskMate, not the later graphical version, which in many ways was far superior. But I've never really seen anybody do a video, at least in depth, about this original version of DeskMate and some of the very interesting and innovative features it had, especially for 1984. Here it describes the features it came with: text, which was word processing, worksheet, which is a spreadsheet, filer, which is a simple database, telecom, which is a communication software, basically a dumb terminal type program, calendar, which is your typical agenda organizer type of thing, and finally mail. That's right, in 1984 the Tandy 1000 came with email software. It says this special program lets you send and receive messages to and from other DeskMate users over the phone. And I don't know if I've ever seen any earlier computer than this that came with email software. So that's what I'm really going to take a look at now, and that is the email software that the Tandy 1000 came with in 1984. Here's the setup I'm using. It's my Tandy 1000 SX computer, which was the successor to the original 1000. It has an internal 2400 baud modem connected to one phone line. Then I have this Tandy WP2 portable word processor. This was actually designed and built by Citizen for Tandy. And it can do more than just word processing. It has a built-in terminal emulator. You can see some of the setup on the screen there. And that is connected to this modem here. It's a US Robotics Courier V34. It's actually a V everything. It just doesn't say that on the front. And that is connected to another phone line. And this was actually one of the intended use cases of the Tandy providing email software, was that you could take your Model 100, which was an earlier version of this kind of laptop computer, you could take it on the road with you, type up a document on this device, and then send it over to the Tandy so you can have it on your desktop computer. And you could also send and receive messages, so if somebody wants to leave you an email, they could type it up on this machine, and then you could dial in using this and read the email and reply back to it. And that's really quite advanced for 1984. So I booted up the Tandy 1000 and I loaded onto it the original version of DeskMate. Well, it's actually version 1.01, but you can see most of the files are still dated 1984. So if I load it up now, my typing desk. There you can see the home screen. So this is the original version of DeskMate, which actually can only run on a Tandy 1000 because it uses the F12 key to save and exit. At the time the Tandy was released, IBM's computers did not have function keys above F10. And when IBM eventually added F11 and F12, they used different scan codes for those keys than Tandy used. So that's why they're not compatible. So the next version of DeskMate, DeskMate 2, was modified to make it compatible with generic PCs because they changed the F12 key to F10. So that's just your little buyer beware. If you're using a generic PC, the original version of DeskMate will not run completely on it. You'll need to use DeskMate 2, but it's mostly the same thing. So with that in mind, I'll just briefly take a look at some of the other features. First is the word processor. And it can do basic things like change the margins. You can see the lines got shorter there. You can do find and replace. You can do cut, copy, and paste. And that's really about it. There's no spell checker. There's no special formatting like bold or italics or different font sizes, although that was not really expected in 1984, even with a full-featured word processor. So a very basic but functional word processor. And to get out of it without saving my changes, I'll press Shift F12 and it asks us cancel edit, and I'll say yes. Next is the worksheet. It comes with these sample files, which is nice. So we can go here, we can change our car payment to $199, and we can do calc. And you can see that total change there to $1194. Doesn't do graphing or anything fancy like that. Just basically entering numbers and totaling them up and things like that. And it comes with these make-believe clients, and I really wonder if these were real addresses and phone numbers, because they're all in the Fort Worth, Texas area, and they have a real area code and number. It's not a 555 number, and they appear to have real addresses. So I don't know, are these real addresses of like Tandy Corporation employees in 1984? You can see another legitimate looking phone number in Arlington, Texas. So I don't know, are these real people? Nothing on the agenda for today, so we can add something here. Today's date beginning at 9 o'clock p.m. ending hopefully around 10 o'clock p.m. Record YouTube video. And now that's on our agenda for today. But anyway, here's the email function. It already has some messages in it. We can read these emails for Laura, dated February 24th, 1985. She got one email from Mom and another one from Jeff. I'm not going to read these here. I'm going to read them on that remote computer when I dial into this. And I'll go into Telcom, because I'll show you the settings I had to use to get this to work reliably. Baud rate is 2400. If you have a faster modem, you can probably bump it up to a faster speed. I chose 7 bits, even parity, and 1 bit, because I was getting some corruption when I did no parity. So I changed it to even parity, and that seems to be more reliable. And I had to custom define the modem settings, because back when this version of DeskMate was released, Tandy was selling modems that were not Hayes compatible. That didn't come until later. So what I did is go into F2, define modem for computer dialing, and you can see the settings I used. Delay 0, send ATDT, and then the number, then send a control M. You actually type a caret symbol to enter that. So you do caret M, and receive is connect in all caps, and that works. And then I go to F3 to set up the answer settings. Delay 0 and send is ATS0 equals 1 caret M, and those are the settings for the answer mode. And what I'll do is I'll do F5 for host mode. It asks us if I want security, but that's not a password or anything, although this can do passwords. What security does is just not show any of the activity on this screen. So if you want to hide what people are dialing in and doing, you enable security. Otherwise, anybody that dials in, it'll show up on this screen. So I'll do no security. And you can already see the menu. And I'm going to dial into this from that other Tandy computer, and we'll see how it works. So here's the remote computer. We're going to make believe we're in a hotel room somewhere 500 miles away, dialing in to our Tandy 1000 at home to send and receive emails to it. So here's the settings I'm using. 2400 baud, word length of 7, even parity, one stop bit, X on, X off is enabled. It's full duplex. And those are the other settings there, which are not really important for what we're doing today. Now I'll do F2 and number 9 to go into telecom mode. It says RS232C is ready. And we're actually now connected to the modem. If I type AT, it says OK. Now I typed in ATDT, which is the command to dial a touch tone number. And I typed in the number I'll be dialing, which I obviously don't want to show on YouTube, so I covered it up. Now I'll just hit Enter. And now it's dialing the number. And now the Tandy is picking up the call. Now it's connected. What you have to do is type Control M. See if I can get this to work. There it goes. And you can see Remote DeskMate, and it has a menu. We have Directory, Read File from Host, Send File to Host, Read Mail, Send Mail, or Log Off. I'm going to read my email. So I'll type number 4, and I'll read the mail for Laura. And there you can see those two messages that are for Laura. So I'll read the email from Mom. I'll type A, and there it is. There's the message from Mom. Got the club room reserved on March 5th at 7 p.m. for our 30th anniversary. Remember, it's still planned as a surprise for your father. Love, Mom. And I believe you type Control C when you're done reading. I want to read that other email. So I'll go back there, read mail for Laura. Oops, typed it wrong. Laura. Now I'll read the email from Jeff. We received the mechanicals for Project 3100 and it's ready to go into Blue Line Tage. It says T-A-G-E. I guess that's some kind of technical term. Do you want to see it again? Okay. Now I'll send an email to number 5. I'll do a email to Jeff from Kevin. Well, Kevin, close enough. I'll type, what is a tag? Because I didn't understand that word. And I'll write in your email, you used the word tag with an E. This is not very fast typing compatible at 2400 baud. You got really take your time when typing, otherwise it'll miss characters. With an E on the end. Close enough. What does this mean? I'll sign off as Kevin and Control C. Let me see if Jeff got the email. So I'll do mail for Jeff. And there, hey, from Kevin. That's my email. So that's the basic function of how sending and receiving email worked back in 1984 on your Tandy 1000 computer. This came for free with the computer. Email. It's unbelievable. But let me go back to the directory. There's more than just email you can do. You can do worksheets, calendars, because this was designed to connect to another computer running DeskMate, so you could open up documents on the remote computer, work on them, and then send them back. It's really amazing. But that wouldn't be really compatible with this kind of device here, because it's not running a full screen. So I won't go into any of this. I just wanted to really show you the email function. So I'll just go back to email, and I'll log off. Remote log off. And I'll type plus 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 ATH to disconnect. And it's disconnected. Now we're back at the Tandy and I'll type F12 to exit host mode. And if we go into our email for Jeff, you see there's the one I sent from the remote computer. And F3 to display, and there you can see exactly what I wrote, spelling mistakes and all. In your email, you used the word tag with an E on the end. What does this mean? And I think you can actually change the emails you receive. So if you want to fix this mistake of not having the E on the, I can go here and add it and then I'll do F12 and I'll save it. And that saved a new email. It's funny, it doesn't display the year correctly. It shows less than 1 instead of 21 or 2021. Although if you go back to the home screen, it shows the full year. So it's kind of like that part works with Y2K and some other parts don't work with Y2K. So this is the software that came for free with your new Tandy 1000 computer in 1984. The original version of DeskMate, which included email in 1984. And unfortunately, although the later graphical versions of DeskMate were a big improvement in ease of use and were actually quite competitive with earlier versions of Mac and Windows, they lost the email and remote access features. So what I just showed in this video was only in the original text-based versions of DeskMate.
Introducing a computer that can change the way you work. The new Tandy 1000, complete with DeskMate software for easy-to-use word processing, filing, worksheets, scheduling, communication. Brought to you by Tandy, clearly superior for service, support, and software. The Tandy 1000, available at Radio Shack computer centers, and so affordable. Tandy technology, service, and support are clearly superior.